He's a native of Florida, from Lakeland. This is his home racetrack. It's also got to be the hardest place for Joe Nemechek to come and race. Back in March in the Craftsman Truck Series race, his younger brother John, running in the top 10 and having his best run in perhaps a year in that series, hit the turn one wall, fatally injured, head injury, claimed John Nemechek. Joe Nemechek, though, races here today from the second row to try to win this one. Joe and Andrea have a son about a month old named John after Joe's late younger brother. This has to be a tough day for Joe Nemechek, but he's doing what he does best, Ed, getting out there and trying to win this race.
Yes, that's the best thing they should be doing. He said it was a little bit tough when he came here to test. That was the toughest day for him, the first day that he came here, but since then he has adjusted and adjusted well, because he is certainly running well.
31 laps away from the curtain of the 1997 Busch Grand National season. Lakeland, Florida's Joe Nemechek in the lead. For Nemechek, a victory today would truly be bittersweet. It was here that his younger brother John suffered fatal head injuries during the Craftsman Truck race back in March.
In my home state, especially here, at Homestead, when so many bad things have happened to our family, it would be wonderful. It'd be definitely a big boost for our whole family.
Wouldn't be a dry eye in the house, Ned.
No, it would be a very, very popular and emotional win. And he deserves, if he wins it, he deserves it, because he's been there all day long, had one of the fastest cars.
His wife, Andrea, new mom, and their son, named John, after Joe's brother.
What a story.
Quite a racing family. Let's go to Ralph. Champion of this series 5 years ago. Here's Dick Berger.
As the race winds down and her husband is leading this event, Andrea Nemechek sits atop the war wagon scoring it. What would it mean for you to have Joe win today, Andrea?
It'd be everything in the world.
Obviously a very emotional moment. Andrea Nemechek.
Tears behind those glasses as Joe Nemechek soldiers on, doing what he knows how to do best, run that car to the front. 25 laps to go. Slaughter calling him clear of the last car he just passed.
It looks so effortless when you see him sitting there in that seat. That car has really been hooked up all day.
It has been there all day. I know he's been complaining. They're saying that his car is better in certain weather conditions, but it looks like to me it's been pretty flat all day long.
The opening laps, then Nemechek went to the front for 29 laps. Jimmy Spencer, Kevin Schwantz have all had a shot at the lead here today. So is Dennis Setzer.
Doing what you're doing. The spread staying the same.
Setzer and Spencer picking up the lead when other leaders pitted. Now he has led since lap 142, 33 laps.
You heard Nemechek's spotter telling him the spread staying the same. What he's telling him is the interval from him back to Glenn Allen, that Glenn's not gaining on him, but Joe's not pulling away. And I'd say right now, with 23 laps to go, that's what Joe needs to do. Just be smooth, drive that car straight off the corner, not get himself in trouble.
And he has the advantage of not having that second place car close enough to distract him from running a smooth line. 14 laps to go. Joe Nemechek trying for his second win of the season in the family-owned NEMCO Chevrolet.
Saying a prayer.
When Joe came out to a driver introduction to Talladega, where we were interviewing some of the drivers, he walked out with his uniform on, the helmet, of course, hanging in the race car. He had his infant son John in one hand and the bottle and the diaper in the other. And he sat there and played dad right up to the point of having to climb up on stage.
Somebody's car is trying to chase down Joe Nemechek. This crew has absolutely got their eyes on the sky, Mike.
out and get gloomy when it's cloudy. And I think that car has picked up a case of it.
And he's actually pulled to about 2.25 second lead over Randy LaJoy now. So he's starting to stretch it out just a little bit with 12 laps to go.
Yeah, we simply talked about it a moment ago being 1.56 seconds ahead. He's now 2.227, so he picked up 3/4 of a second. Here's down to the 30.
Mark Martin's got it. Now here comes Steve Park. He is a lap down in 12th place. Joe's dad has been with him, the team owner, these many years. His mom, Martha, always in the garage area, always with a camera at the ready, taking pictures, sending them out to everybody involved in motorsports.
A rocket ship on the back.
Helping chronicle his career. That was Joe talking about...
I'm a lot better in turn two than I am turn four.
Focusing on how that car is handling. He's got to coax it around five more times. Four this time by.
You heard his spotter tell him, I guess it was a rocket ship, and Joe said he's a lot better off turn two. That's going to make it run down the back straight away a lot better.
Well, it's cut down. About a tenth of a second off of the lead that time. But he'll need more than a tenth of a second per lap. LaJoy will to catch him because he's still over a second behind with 3.5 laps to go.
Couple of cars in front of Joe Nemechek. Hermie Sadler, he'll probably catch him maybe down the front straightaway. It'd be a lot better to catch him on the front straightaway than down in turn one and two.
Laps to go. And LaJoy draws ever closer. Mark Martin is still third. Glenn Allen, fourth. Jimmy Spencer, fifth. Todd Bodine, running in sixth, would be the second place point man. Seventh, Dennis Setzer, who would hold on the 20th and that $30,000 check tomorrow night. Matt Kenseth, eighth. Kevin Schwann, Kent, and Joe Becky.
Good battles going on between Dennis Setzer and Kenseth in the 17 car, and also Tim Fedua and Kevin Schwann are battling for positions back there as we watch this thing unfold here at the end.
Traffic for Joe Nemechek. He works his way around the outside. Here comes LaJoy.
Ernie really made a nice catch of that. He moved almost all the way below the white line.
And another car that Nemechek is coming up passing just goes right on by. No problem for either driver.
But look at LaJoy diving into turn three. He really took it in there deep. One lap to go. And the hand of fate that has been so cruel to the Nemechek family. Trouble is it's Fedua who has spun. White flag is out. And now they'll race to the checker no matter what.
And there's more trouble up in turns three and four. Evidently someone lost an engine or something.
Setzer in the wall. Setzer in the fence. They'll have to come to the checkered flag. As the hand of fate brings the yellow flag out, Nemechek comes into dark territory. LaJoy closes even further as they slide through turn three. Setzer gets running on the brakes as he gets there. Here comes LaJoy. Down to the track apron. A drag race around the left car. And Joe Nemechek will win it.
What a win. What a run. Boy, that was close all the way through turn three and four.
And that hand of fate waves kindly over brother. Joe Nemechek.
Everybody did a heck of a job, man. I'm proud of every one of you, man. This means a lot. Take one for John. The victory lap for John.
It can't mean enough to Joe Nemechek, but certainly it means a lot. Collecting his thoughts.
Hey, Joe, let's do one backwards, bud. Do one backwards.
Talking about the famous Polish victory lap that Alan Quickie made so famous as he spins it around here. Start-finish line is going to make the Polish victory lap in honor of his
brother. Don't turn that, sir. Do one backwards, bud. All the way around.
Fans are just going crazy.
He pulls up to Randy LaJoy.
Check the champion of this race coming out.
34 years of age.
For 21 years, he's been a racer. racer. And never a day like this. Joe, congratulations. What a beautiful race.
I just can't say enough. I mean, what an emotional day. Bell South Mobility Chevrolet Monte Carlo was awesome. The guys just had excellent stops, and I got kind of lucky there at the end. I got away on the restart, and I knew Randy would be coming, and Mark Martin, and whoever else was back there. And I just don't know what to say. This one's for John. I know he was watching over us. We had an awesome race car. Engines ran good. Just everything was perfect.
Last lap, your spotter did a fantastic job for you. How about describing that last lap for us? What was going through your mind when you came on that incident up in turn three and then brought it home?
I saw a car wrecked going down the back straightaway, and the thing was halfway gone. It was the 33 car, Tim Fito, and I saw Randy LaJoie really coming fast. And they said, there's more wrecked cars coming off. And I got over to the exit of the corner, and people went down the apron. They kind of blocked all my avenues. And I said, I got to shoot through the middle, and just held her wide open. And just lucky the gap didn't close, and we squeezed through. Unbelievable.
Last lap coming off the fourth turn, realizing it was yours. Give us an idea of how you felt.
There's a lot of emotion. This is in 1 year to have a tragedy, have my brother, my best friend, die down here, and then come back here and win a race. Unbelievable.
Andrea, that was some moment, wasn't it?
That was awesome.
Now, what was the reaction of the expert here?
Oh, I don't think he knows what to think.
Congratulations to all of you for a wonderful afternoon and a great race. Let's go to Dick Bergen.